Good morning, friends. I am Venkat Shiv Kumar and a chartered accountant. More than a chartered accountant, I have been a teacher. I have started my journey as a teacher since 1988. And thereafter, in 2000, I started publishing a news magazine called Sharp. Sharp CA Student. Based on that, I used to gather information, but basically I started for students. But then slowly the council members of that time have influenced me, I can say, to speak about the institute affairs, which are directly related to students, members, and the staff. So, I used to interact with three people mainly, very closely. Mr. N.D. Gupta, he was the president in 2001. And then one Mr. Manoharan is another, I think you remember him, he was our ex-president. Then we had Santana Krishna. These three people used to influence me a lot. More I was close to Santana Krishna, who had he was having very strong views about the functioning of the institute and their need for great structural changes. And I'm not a knowledgeable person at any given time, except for knowledge in subject which I was teaching for CA inter and final students. I am new to this politics. Actually, I was going on talking nicely about everybody. He is great, this man is great, that man is great. So then I happened to meet Mr. Santana Krishnan, SKPKF, some company, some firm is running. Then he asked me some questions. What is the use of going on praising this man is good, that man is good? What do you want? If you want to bring, institute is a corrupt body. And if you want to do the reforms, paper is a good medium. And he is a very knowledgeable person. In fact, I should recollect, at that point in time, somewhere when it was Mr. Manoharan was a teacher and he was contesting the election, the Society of Auditors called for meeting of everybody, contestants. And at that point in time, Mr. Manoharan has said like this: everybody is asking me whether ICAI is at crossroads. You believe me, it is in 2001, I think so, or some, I don't remember because it's almost 20 years gone. But this is a meeting, I remember. He started with his explanation saying that, is our CA Institute as crossroads? Everybody asked me. For this, Mr. Manoharan said, no, CA is not, ICA is not at crossroads, but it has reached a dead end. That is the, that are the comments he made. Then Mr. Santana Krishnan was close to one Mr. N.D. Gupta, who is the member of parliament for Aam Aadmi Party. That time he was in Congress. Then Santana Krishnan used to tell me he's a great man, fantastic personality, so many things. He's our man. So I was only fascinated by him. He's a very simple person. And he doesn't know much English, you know, he speaks in Hindi only. But he is a very knowledgeable person. So I had no other things except praising these people. Daily, every 15 days I have to publish this magazine. Therefore, I don't have much information about institute, and I was not having legal knowledge that time. So that is how I started my journey. I didn't know much, but whatever Santhana Krishnan says, I used to write. And see, this is a very difficult game, but then I voluntarily or involuntarily have taken up that. But I had a concern for the students, the education system. Why the students are being failed like this? A lot of mistakes. CA Institute examination system is absolutely, examination system is good, but the way they are asking questions and all that were poorly educated checking was there that time. In fact, I filed several cases against this ICAI for reforming the education system. Though the court was in favor of the institute, but then the institute realized they cannot carry on doing all such mistakes. That was the filing a case, you may not get a favorable order or otherwise, but that will reform the institution. A lot of improvements have taken place post the several cases on education. Then what happened is the institute, you must have seen what Mr. Manoharan, as a president, vice president earlier, he is, even now he keeps on talking about sermons and all. But that time he is a highly agitated personality, like Amitabh Bachchan, young, angry man. So he used to always talk about sermons, and he coined saying that self above, service about self, institution above individual, Jai Hind, Jai Bharat, Jai ICI. This one is, you please read, everything was there. So he has positioned himself as a very noble person, and he won in thumping majority first time, second time. He's a teacher. Everybody had great things, but after he became president, he has become an ordinary person. But he had people around him in the regional council who projected him as a savior, messiah. Satyam Computers, it was a very good company, Satyam Computers, with lot of assets, having 6 months working capital. But because it's a South Indian run company, you know, North finished us, and that became a standard for every talking now. Now we have seen lakhs of crores is going, but nothing is going to happen. So he has taken the full credit, he got Padma Shri. And I remember one more thing. He told in that election, first time when he was contesting, he was such a pious thing he had given to everybody. I'm talking about how this institution is reformed, I mean changed over this 20 years time. He said, many people ask me, why you don't do bank audits? That was question somebody posed. He was telling the audience. I said, no. I want youngsters to pick up this bank current concurrent audits. So I decided not to conduct the, take up the audits. He said that. Because if I take that opportunity which would have gone to an young person has lost, he said. Amazing. You can see he is the Mahatma Gandhi of ICAI. But after president he became, then he started aspiring for all big positions. Padma Shri he got. And everywhere, you know, he is a tax man. He doesn't have any knowledge in economics. He said himself on record. Banking he doesn't know. But he started taking chairmanships of this, the RBI expert committee he was appointed. Because he was very close to the Ministry of Corporate Affairs. Why this example I have taken? Yes, you may. I think he is one, maybe among all the council members so far, is nobody could speak, give slogans like him. Nobody could make everybody believe that he is a man, is beyond all thing. Sermons, every time, even now I think in every conference he will be called, he will have to come and he will talk about sermons. But the institute during this period has passed through deadly period. Bank of Baroda, first time removed concurrent auditors, 1,000 people, 1,000 auditors have lost. Then I filed a writ petition. You know, if every bank starts taking that stand, then our profession will be in trouble. For that, all presidents say, don't depend on bank audits. You learn technology, that is what it is. We thought, at least Mr. Manoharan will call, give a call, try to persuade the Reserve Bank. Audit is definitely important. There is nobody is doing charity for us. One or two mistakes auditors are doing is being magnified like anything. No auditor would like to get to jail. But then the system is like that. He never gave a call. Why I am taking him as example is, if he is not calling, all other fellows, all other presidents accept that, yes, we are coming here for positions. We would like to control and then benefit from the system. No doubts about it. But this gentleman is one cut among the rest who has given. Then came Mr. Narendra Shah, Subodh Kumar Agarwal, Mr. Ved Jain, all these guys, one way or the other, indulged in what Madras High Court, Honorable Madras High Court said. When you go through the details of the committee meeting, you will realize that there is they are misusing. A person having disciplinary jurisdiction cannot misuse like this, was the conclusion of Honorable Madras High Court. Mr. Manoharan did not raise one word against it. He has achieved everything from the platform of institute, and then he has gone there. Then, you know, irony is that this Narendra Shah has refunded the money, because the Honorable Judge clearly told him, if he is not going to refund, we will put him in jail. CBI inquiry I will order against the Institute Affairs. Nobody took action till all the presidents are talking. No, till now, no action was taken against Mr. Narendra Shah, Mr. Ved Jain. And they made sure the disciplinary committee is headed by one BSc graduate who had no legal knowledge, no accounting knowledge, who was passing orders, absolving all the Central Council members, whoever is there. I'll tell you a simple situation. Mr. Bhupati, when he was a president, he filed cases against me because I wrote against him, and that has damaged the institute. That was the case, criminal case, civil defamation, everything he filed. Of course, I didn't know law that time, so I've been running after this, that and all. But in a similar case, one member called the president of that time as a dog, who throw biscuits against that fellow, he will re-eat. Like that he publicly said. I filed a DC case. Then the same DC committee took a stand. If Mr. X calls that president as a dog, and that dog only should file case, not the institute. This is same. One for me, another for him. So, complete misuse of disciplinary jurisdiction. As a result, it's gone to NEFRA. And it's better that it's gone to NEFRA. They are doing great job. They are doing great job. Only thing, they should not involve the CA presidents and other fellows in that committee. Otherwise, again, NEFRA will become like that. So, very good, and we appreciate. I filed ICAI. My emblem is being used by a ICAA institute, misrepresenting. Nobody took. I fought. Nobody. Everybody is not bothered at all. Only members and students were bothered. And in fact, the institute went against. So they didn't take any action. which they could have taken. And all these central council members are there, whom about whom I am going to talk about. So therefore, friends, you don't go by, these elections are coming in December. I am trying to educate or share. I may be a biased person. So therefore, I would request you to apply your mind and then accordingly take a decision. What these council members can do and what they will do. Instead of telling what council members can do for the profession, what they cannot do for the profession is what is going to be my discussion. Believe me, I have no personal grievance against any person. But definitely, ours is a very great institution. One of the best institutions. Education. Every chartered accountant is flourishing. Doing a lot of good work. If many companies are surviving and growing, it's because of the finance brain, the chartered accountants. But then, is it worth for us to ignore our ICAI and leave it to these council members to take whatever decisions they like? Or we should proactively involve ourselves in choosing the right candidate who has some conscience. See, why these people are not talking in favor of our institute and profession is because they are afraid their positions may be lost. They are aspiring, even at 65, 70 years old, guys, they want to grow further for themselves, for their children, for their grandchildren. Taking that holistic view, they are not talking anything. So, if you have a really concerned person, conscience is there, he will definitely take up the issue. We had three teachers. Mr. Bhupati, he won because he was a teacher. And you know what, how much galata it took place. Then came Manohara. This gentleman, sermon, slogans. Where is he now? He is becoming expert committee member of Reserve Bank of India when he is not having no knowledge, no work. He has not published any papers. He didn't do PhD. He is simple income tax expert. Specialized in settlement commission. That's all. And now he is talking good behavior. Everywhere he will tell what is good behavior, how to keep peacefully. But he will talk in every conference. He is without him, nobody will, no chairman can go ahead. This is what is happening. Then came MP Vijay Kumar. Mr. Vijay Kumar is a good person. He is a genuinely good person. He has done, he has reached, he is a teacher, excellence. And two terms he conduct, he must have done a lot of work in accounting standards. Then he must have realized that it's not possible for him to proceed further. So he dropped out. So even the good persons, for reasons best known to them, are not continuing. So that means what is the position? And now you can see, friends, most important topics I will discounsel. Mr. Atul Gupta was the president. This gentleman, what he did, I'll tell you. The government asked 10 crores of rupees as a donation for that PM Care Fund. Injati Srinivas was the secretary, MCA. This man gave 21 crores, not his money, the money of the CA Institute. And I can tell you that every council member told last 6 months he was only concentrating to become the member of IFAC. He told me, promised me, he'll support me in ICWA case. Madras High Court, I would have won it. Review petition was there. He did not take up the mic. First 6 months, he was talking nicely. Bade bhai, like that. Nobody taken. What did these council members do? When the government asked 10 crores, you gave 21 crores of students and public members' money. Is it not morally responsible for you to take opinion? No. And then he became IFAC member. What a dangerous precedent he set. is gone. Now we got one other person, the current president. He was working in Reliance, I think. And now he has come as the president. Reliance means what they want, whatever they want, it will happen. Now, when so many problems are there, this man says, I will make ICA Hindi driven. Who is it, the burning issue for us? South India is not there. Now you make everything Hindi. Accounting standards will be in Hindi. And you will argue in the world. And globalization, all this you are talking. Such is the persons. Now the president exercises full powers. But then what are these council members doing? 32 council members handling so many committees, saying I did this, I did. What is the use? We don't have controller and auditor general doing audit. Full powers are given to the president, and then president forms a former president's club. All their deeds are suppressed. So this is our institute to correct themselves, ourselves. It's very simple. The council which gets in, new council, who are the new council members, let us take. I'll talk to them about it detailedly, but we need a dynamic council members, a group, at least 5 people who can raise the issues. Let the issues be solved or not. There's nobody from south who can take. All are playing safe. Only that one Mr. Tarun Ghia, and he did. You see, one very important, the 100 crore scam, I won only because everybody is giving credit to me. I don't deserve that. I won 100 crores because one Mr. P.S. Prabhakar was there. He got me the minutes of the 323 council meeting. He published in Society of Auditors. Took a bold step to help me. One Mr. M.R. Venkatesh, who got it. Mr. Gurumurthy wrote letters. These people who are not council members did it. And it was created as a movement. He published it. And when the matter came up for hearing, in the last hearing, they put Advocate General Mr. P.S. Raman, Mr. Narayanan, and Mr. Somayajuluji, and Mr. Chandran also came. 4 Advocate Generals were fighting for the respondents. And I won only because of that minutes of the meeting. I was no good speaker either that time. I was just started, I completed my LLB, LLM and started sitting there. Only thing is I had courage to stand before the court. And the Honorable Judge Sasidharanji understood there is some problem. But then how to establish? Vijay Narayanaji is there, Raman sir is there, Somayajuluji is there. And then 10 people will come. 300 lakhs plus they have spent for defending Mr. Shah, defending Mr. Ved Jain. And finally, I showed this. And in that minutes, everybody expressed resentment. Judge read it, that's all. Not even 3 minutes I argued. I won the case. He paid back that money, 7 crores. 3 crores he didn't pay. 3 crores, no, president took action. It's our money. No, the Manoharan sir, who is such a great person, man of sermons, he didn't open his mouth also. When he is a lighthouse for the CA Institute, he claims himself is become dark. So, dear friends, we now need the council, a vibrant council. Somebody should raise questions. Now, when this president wrote in his CA journal that he is going to make it Hindi and make India one unit language, such a one-sided person, orthodox, he is insensitive president. He is telling feelings of South Indians was just forgot. Now we have Rajendra Kumar Jain and Mr. Dayanivas Sharma. They are all good friends to me. Rajendra Kumar is my student from CA Foundation. Very nice fellow. Daya Nivas Sharma, absolutely polite, good, knowledgeable. But they will only support the other Central Council, which is fully Central Council, whether it is East, West, North, it is only by Mr. Marwadis. I mean, with great respect to all of them, Jains and Maheshwaris, they will be majority. So now it is going to be, we have to protect our language itself. After some time you will forget your Tamil, Telugu. We are not against Hindi, please note. I speak Hindi, I read Ramayana and all, everything. But is it correct to enforce your likes? Why don't you learn Tamil? You learn Tamil and make it Tamil as the oldest language. He is doing like this. Therefore, you must think twice before electing persons. And I am going to talk about the Central Council region wise. What is in store for us? What will happen? And we can only plead these people to look after the interest of the profession. Always you are worried about MCA. CA, the student studies so hard. Today risk is increased. For everything they are putting CAs in jail. And the government is unhappy with us. Ever since this Honorable Modi took over, they are trying to, maybe that's partly good because NEFRA came, everybody is appreciating the hard work of NEFRA. Nobody is against CA, ICI. There is one Professor Narayana Swami is there. He is not against, why are you taking him against? He is talking truth. And bluntly, that's the difference. And this council doesn't change. Every president coming and talking and doing like this. What is the reputation CA Institute built over by the old presidents who took up the CA as a mother? Correct? No. That is the purpose of my lecture. So this is my background. Now friends, I have become a master's in law. I am doing doctorate. I am good. My agenda I will tell you. These 3 years I will ensure that Controller and Auditor General Audit will come. Even friends, for this election, they are spending 400 crores by sending the pamphlets, colored pamphlets. One Prabhu, my student and a former chairman of Bangalore branch, 2 years he's been fighting with the institute saying, why are you spending so much money? RTI collected 325 lakhs. In an electronic age, you can send by email. But you want to do it because once a Central Council member wins, next 2 times is assured for him. Did the rule say color photos should be sent? No. But the president is least bothered about it, this man. And he is telling Hindi, introduce. So therefore friends, this part one, I have just introduced you to about myself. Second is about the issues being faced by the profession. The greatest of our professions. You please remember, institutional independence is the basic bedrocks for this democratic functioning. You can see Honorable Supreme Court, ever after Ramana, CJI, from Andhra Pradesh, he is not Andhra Pradesh, he is India. He came and made the Indians proud. The respect to the judiciary, the top court, the protector of fundamental rights has gone up many fold. So a right president, a right council can solve these problems in no time. Why are you hesitating to appoint an independent auditor? Why are you hesitating to have a Central Council AGM? Why are you not replying to the sincere efforts taken by my friend Sashikant, Deep Jain and Amresh Vasist, all those people? Relentlessly they are writing, these are the mistakes, this is the fraud, this is the foreign travels. Why are you doing it? What can more they do? How much time will be wasted? No, they are not lawyers. I am lawyer, I am fighting for them. So, is this going to continue? And see, today the CA Institute is not respected, seen at disregard. Why? CA Institute is a great institute. Why should anybody respect it? It's going to be a great institution like Supreme Court. But these people, these council members, Some are good, but they can't do anything. Mass majority of the people have an agenda. They want themselves to be MPs, their sons to be MPs, their grandsons to be MPs. But they will tell, they will give slogans. Everything for them only. Even at 70 years, what you will do? You can please serve our profession. And let us first select good council members. Who are the good council members? I am talking on the part 2.